Gotcha. He was just hanging out up there. Hey guys, this is Jeremy. I'm back on the Minecraft server. I'm gonna get you. And I wanted to do a little bit of farming with you guys. I don't know if you guys have not seen, I assume nobody else has shown it at this point. But actually, let me show you this. So we have a whole bunch of different changes over here on our shopping center. And I've added one of those. Stephen Holtz, who goes by S. Wesley, has a place over here, which is kind of like Tiny Towers, an mobile app game that you guys can play. And so he's built his own little tiny towers, and mine is the one on top. And I don't know if I'm calling it Precious Moments or the Necessary Items. I don't know what I'm calling it, but it's a whole bunch of expensive stuff. And I did have three of these guys in here. And he took two of them so he could get a beacon. And I'm selling them for 3 diamonds each. So my rent is paid for a little while because he's renting all these spaces out. So I actually need to go get some more wither skulls. So I figured I'd do a little bit of that farming with you guys, see if I get anything. For me, the farm rate with our withers is drastically low as far as actually getting skulls, but we'll see what we can do. So I'll show you guys that. I haven't shown you guys the actual wither farm. It's nothing impressive. In fact, it could use a lot of optimization in this process, but I figured I would take you guys there, do some wither farming, see if I can get anything. I can show you guys our I don't know if I've shown you guys the, what are they called? Oh, this is terrible. The blaze farm that we have. So I'll take you guys over here, show you guys this, do some farming. While we're doing this, the topic I wanted to talk to you guys about today for this series, actually before I get into that, one of the things you pass by is the arena, which is over there. Sean created that. It's where we're going to eventually do a big wither boss fight. It's not indestructible, so there'll have to be a lot of repairs done to it, but he wanted it to be aesthetically pleasing. This is our blaze farm. You gotta be up there because that's where the spawner is, but you come down here and farm them. Which I'm always amazed at how much the graphics kill that. You can hear them in there. So that's the farm for that. And then this is the wither farm. We'll see if we can get anything. But the topic I want to talk to you guys about is I am of the utmost supporter, I guess, of making sure you value whatever it is that you are doing. And as church tech people, I don't think that sometimes we value things that we should value as much as possible. To date this episode, John Acuff had a post recently that said, if I'm going to take one of my mentors out, I'm not going to just pay for a 4.25 coffee because their time is worth more than that, 4.25 an hour. And that really inspires me to just think about how you value stuff. And I totally agree. My volunteers, obviously for them, I want to get them something and I can't do a ton of stuff, but my volunteers, I always make sure that I pay for a meal or pay for something because they're giving up their time for helping serve in a ministry. That's always absolutely important for me. Youth ministry, it used to be, let's have movie nights, let me take care of all the snacks and the movie and the location, and we'll kind of go from there. So for me, that's important to be able to not only honor the people I'm with, but also show them the kind of respect I think that's important in that process. And it's not just a little bit of respect, it's recognizing that there's can be an actual fiscal number to that process and what that looks like. And that's for volunteers that may be working with you, under you, and I don't necessarily want to say that they're worth less. It's just that they've made that commitment and they get something out of it for volunteering with you guys. So do make sure you value them in some way. Here, I'm going to burn these. There you go. Do make sure you value them, but keep within reason, certainly. That being said, I don't think that ministries do that enough from what I know of. Certainly there are exceptions to that rule. But I wonder what that means for a lot of people as far as trying to value doing things well in a ministry standpoint. And I think it goes beyond that in the sense of when you're online, when you're doing social media, when you're blogging, when you are connecting with people online, are you showing value there as well? I think that for a lot of people, that value that needs to be shown doesn't happen. Let me give you an example of that. I think that this is just killing my mob rate. An example of that is that for people that are on social media, they want to get traffic to their sites. And so how much do you price that at? If you were to give it a fiscal price, how much would you say a loyal follower is? How much would you pay for that if you had to pay for it? Or how much would you price it at if you had to give them a certain amount? And I think that we would say, oh, they're extremely valuable, everything that goes with that. And then we would turn around and say, and what's the free tool that we can use to do social media or blogging? What's the cheapest way that we can get out our message to our audience? And it's just this false aspect of saying that you do value your that you value your readers, that you value the content that you're putting together, and then you don't actually do anything with it. I love the Church Mag model where we actually pay our bloggers, and I wish we could pay them more because the content that we come out with is typically amazing compared to just what is being put out there. But we try to value it as best as possible to keep the whole system running. But there's a lot of people out there that expect things for free, and that's tough for me. I'm not bashing people that are giving it away for free, but it is showing what the value is in that process. And you can say, oh, but you get the recognition, you get the recognition. The recognition is something that I already have, and I don't think is that valuable because I have my own platform I'd like to do. I am giving you value by writing something for your websites, and you're saying that the traffic that I would get, which is, let's be honest, not that much traffic, is more valuable than any kind of monetary thing that you could give. And I want to go beyond just the guest post. I want to go to what you think as far as your own social media presence. What does that look like for you? Dang, these guys are everywhere. What does that look like for you? Are you willing to actually make an investment if this is something that is investment worthy? Or is it just something that you're doing on the side and that's kind of how you need to value it? And be honest with yourself. Be honest with your audience. Don't say, oh, we're going to make sure we make the greatest church website available and then not actually do anything with it. Man, these guys are crazy. I don't want to speak too much on the. Let me tell you guys where all this came from. This isn't just something that I wanted to complain about. For me, all of this came down to the conversation I had recently with what does it mean to blog or post social media. And some people would say that the best way to do it is to have reoccurring posts. You need to make the most effective use of your content that you are sharing online. And that means that you need to use, reuse, and reuse that content, which recycling content, repurposing it, absolutely important. But is it a matter of maximizing efforts or just trying to be cheap and cheap with your time at this point? Is that what you're saying as far as the value for your audience? And I think for some people it is. It's if they're being honest with themselves, they're just being cheap about it. They're not willing to actually put that back effort into it. Man, come on. This is going to be bad to farm these guys whenever the new update comes and there's a new combat format. I have to look at how people go about that. So what does that mean for you as your audience? Are you actually putting in the effort? Are you actually giving it your all? And how do you go about that well? I think that that's a tough conversation for people to have, mostly because they don't have a good answer for it. So they don't have a, well, this is why you would do this. This is how you would best go about it. This is the exact number of what my audience would be worth. And I don't think that we have that. I know that for Church Mag, we actually have a list of people that are influential, and we are trying to figure out how best to get them on and what that would cost in that process. We actually have a financial value of what a blog post is. And so we've thought through that process and we know what it's worth to the point that we're willing to pay for something like this Minecraft server because we value our audience and we want them to feel valued. And if we love gaming and if they want to join in the gaming, that community for us is extremely important. Certainly, we're getting other content out of it, which is wonderful. This in and of itself is great, but we do this as much or more for you guys. Because honestly, I could sit here and play Minecraft and enjoy it. I could play Minecraft and do all this stuff on a private server, but I do this in this manner because I want to be able to connect with people. And Eric is 100% on board. In fact, he has said that this is one of the best things that he's invested in recently, and I love that. I love that he has that vision about that he can recognize investing in the audience is actually something worthwhile. All right, I'm gonna just take you guys out with this from a distance. So what does it mean to value your team? What is your audience worth? If you could have, and there's, let's be honest, there's several different kinds of traffic. There's about a fifth of Church Mag's traffic is from search engines, and it's not something that we went out and found. And so there's a value for search engines and SEO, and we have a specific value, which is why we pay for some plugins with that. So which is why we have a SEO optimized template and design theme, and we are willing to go for that expense. We recognize that a lot of people have that direct connection, and what is that value worth? And so we need to work on that process as well. And I think Eric has done an amazing job with trying to just factor in that value and factor in how we target those people. But I don't think with church technology we do that. And some of you guys might be saying that I'm overthinking this process. And if you're just doing a blog to kind of get words on a piece of paper and you don't necessarily think it's worth anything, then you're probably right. You are overdoing it. Just get a free blog spot websites and kind of share things. But if you're actually wanting to impact the kingdom, what is it worth to you? How much time, energy, effort are you willing to put into this? And I think that that time can be a price. I did a case study recently about the best computer setup I could get, and one of the parts of the setup was to do a standing desk, which I'm actually working on right now. And Michael Hyatt responded and said, "Hey, don't forget that part of the cost of having a standing desk, if you're going to make it yourself and do a DIY, is that time that you actually have to put in to create it." Which honestly, I didn't think about at that point because it was more of a monetary concern than anything. But he's right. That time that you invest in that blog to make that first article you post is absolutely important. And people always are looking for how to trim down that time you're investing in the blog. But I would encourage you to try to figure out how you can best use your time and maybe even increase the amount of time you put into creating blog articles, because you're just adding value to that process. And you're saying, you guys are worth it. So this content I'm sharing with you guys is worth it. So I'd love to hear what you guys have to say with this. Got a little bit more farming to do. Haven't gotten anything. The spawn rates, man, for these skulls. I remember the first time I did this, it took me probably about 600 kills before I got anything. And then after that, I got a second and third one in about 25 kills. So, yeah. Who knows how they calculate that? Still nothing. I do like to use my sword on the pigs because I still need a lot of gold. Our gold farm isn't working right now, so I always need to make sure I put a lot of energy as far as resources to get the gold. Once we get that farm going up, I'm gonna not worry about the pigmen as much, but I always try to kill them when I can, which coincidentally can be very deadly, but that's okay. I've ended up in lava at least twice now because of pigmen. Alright, so I'd love to hear what you guys have to say. What does it mean to value content for you guys? Am I blowing this way out of proportion? Am I making a mountain out of a molehill, as sometimes I feel like I do whenever I talk about these topics, and frankly make people angry? Or are you on that side of you need to actually have value, and how do you determine that value? We have our own way as far as the church mag, but how do you guys value that as far as your audience, as far as your content that you're creating, as far as the time that you invest in it, and to justify the work? And what does that mean for you? So leave you guys comments down below. Hopefully I get some wither skulls. I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.